In 2010 of the imperial calendar, the Holy Britannia Empire declared war on Japan for its underground resources. In the decisive battle for the mainland, the Britannia forces introduced the humanoid autonomous battle-armored knights, known as the Nightmare Frame, into actual combat. As their power was far greater than anticipated, the mainland defense line of the Japanese forces was completely broken. Defeated, Japan became a dominion of the empire and was renamed Area 11, while the Japanese were called 11. In the ruins, a young man told his fellow that he would definitely destroy Britannia one day. This man is our lead, Leloche. 7 years later in the Tokyo settlement where Britannias live, Leloche is playing chess for a guy. Leloche is a clever student in a noble school, but he uses his intelligence to gamble money for others. His opponent is very arrogant, believing that himself is going to be the winner. However, Leloche easily wins the game that was going to lose. After taking his pay, Leloche walks out and sees Clovis, the third prince of Britannia Empire in charge of Area 11, speaking on the screen. The prince announces that he will not allow terrorist acts and will mourn the dead and injured. After the speech, he takes off his cloak to attend the banquet, but is told that the terrorists have stolen a chemical weapon, then escaped. The prince angrily sends his personal troop, the Nightmares, to pursue. In the meantime, Leloche is driving back to the school with his fellow Rivales when they are almost hit by a truck. When Leloche goes to save people in the truck, he surprisingly finds that the truck was actually hijacked by them. In this way, he is taken away by the truck and involved in the battle. What terrorists stole is poisonous gas, which once released will cause unimaginable consequences. The truck eventually stops at Shinjuku Ghetto, and the army sends honorary Britannia troops to investigate. One of the soldiers finds Leloche and knocks him down, but when he sees Leloche's face, his attitude changes immediately. When the soldier takes off his mask, Leloche finds that he is none other than his childhood friend, Suzaku. When Leloche questions him why joining the Britannia army, the gas canister suddenly opens. Suzaku jumps forward and puts a gas mask on Leloche's face, but there is no poison gas in the canister at all, but a green-haired girl. At this time, the chief arrives with their soldiers and criticizes Suzaku, asking him to shoot Leloche to make up for his fault, but Suzaku says he will not kill a civilian. Without further ado, the chief shoots down Suzaku. Just when they are going to kill Leloche, the truck explodes, and Leloche takes the opportunity to escape with the girl. At the same time, in order to prevent the girl's secret from leaking, the prince orders the army to kill all the residents in the Shinjuku ghetto where Leloche is caught by the army because of his phone ringing. As Leloche is going to be killed, the girl rushes forward and takes the shot for him. Seeing the girl die, Leloche is confounded, but the girl suddenly grabs his hand and brings Leloche into the consciousness space. The girl says that she can give him power, but her deal is that Leloche should fulfill her wish. The power of the king will isolate him. If he can go on with all this, then he can accept the contract. Leloche remembers that his revenge has not been taken yet, so he decides to make the deal with the girl. He acquires the power called Geist, which can control people's mind. As he orders the soldiers present to die, all of them shoot themselves immediately. Looking at the dead bodies before him, Leloche realizes that he has to live a life full of lies in the future. Meanwhile, a female soldier, Valletta, driving a nightmare, rushes in. Seeing bodies on the ground, she questions who Leloche is. Leloche tries to use Geist on Valletta, but he finds that his skills only work when looking into her eyes, so he claims himself as a noble student and asks for protection to get Violetta out. Violetta believes it, but as soon as she comes down, she is controlled by Leloche and hands her nightmare over to him obediently. When she comes to her senses, she is confused about why she is standing there. On the other side, a pocket watch on his chest saves Suzuku's life. A scientist, Lloyd, watches Suzuku to test his 7th grade generation nightmare, Lancelot. Normally, the nightmare can only be driven by Britannians of pure blood, but Lloyd believes that only Suzaku can play Lancelot's greatest value. After getting Nightmare, Leloche learns that Shinjuku is implementing traffic restrictions at present after contacting his friend Shirley, so infers that the military will not reinforce for a while. His Nightmare can see the position of all Britannia soldiers, so he plans to play the game of chess with them. He contacts the terrorists and helps the female terrorist called Colin get rid of the pursuit and get many new nightmares. Leloche asks the terrorist to follow his command, and the terrorist leader Augie agrees, for there is no better way than listening to him now. Under the command of Lelouch, the terrorist eventually destroys the Britannia army through underground ambush. After hearing the news of failure, Clovis has no choice but asks Lloyd to send his newly developed nightmare, Lancelot. Therefore, Suzuku sets off with Lancelot, which quickly defeats all terrorists with amazing combat power, astonishing Lelouch very much. Soon, Suzuku finds the commander, who he doesn't recognize as Lelouch for being unable to see his face. Suzuku keeps pursuing Lelouch, though having an excellent strategic mind in the face of the crushing power, Lelouch has to flee. But Suzuku won't let him. As Lelouch strafes an old building, a woman holding a child falls from it. Lelouch uses the opportunity to escape when Suzuku rushes to save them. Lelouch uses Gius to meet Clovis and orders him to stop the slaughtering. Clovis does what he is told and asks who Lelouch is. Lelouch takes off his mask and astonishes Clovis. It turns out that Lelouch is the 17th prince of the Holy Britannia Empire and the half-brother of Clovis. Clovis thought Lelouch had already died in the war, so is very surprised to see him here. Lelouch asks him if he knows the cause of death of his mother Mariana, but Clovis only says that he is not the killer. Even by Gius, Lelouch only finds out that the second prince Sneasel and the second princess Cornelia had investigated a lot about this incident. Seeing that Clovis has no more information to offer, Lelouch shoots and kills him. The next day, Lelouch returns to school and sees a female classmate who has never come to school before. The girl is none other than Colin. After finding the opportunity to be alone, Lelouch takes control of Colin with Gius. After confirming that she is one of the terrorists that day, he asks why she takes part in such terrorist activities. Although Colin is a noble lady, her mother is Japanese, so Colin regards herself as a Japanese person. When Lelouch is about to leave after questioning, he uses Gius again to give an order that Colin will say nothing to Shinjuku, but this time, Gius fails. Fortunately, Shirley meets Lelouch at this moment, so he seizes the time to run away. Lelouch lives with his sister Nunali, who is paralyzed and blind and is taken care of by the Japanese maid Sayoko. At the dinner, Nunali answers that she wishes nothing but world peace. Then Lelouch says, smiling, that it will come true when she can see again. The next day, Lelouch tests Gius on a teacher and finds out that this skill can only work once for the same person. After the last meeting, Colin thinks that Lelouch's voice is similar to the person who ordered them that day, so she is dubious about him. If her identity is exposed, it is necessary to kill Lelouch as soon as possible, and meanwhile, Lelouch is also thinking about killing her. After school, he invites Colin to come over to the student council's office alone, but suddenly it turns into a welcome party for Colin to join the student council. In the chaos, Colin's clothes are wet with champagne, so she has to take a shower and change clothes. When Lelouch gives a change of clothes to Colin, she suddenly grabs his wrist, trying to find out whether he is the commander. However, Lelouch has already used Gius to control Sayuku to call Colin and play his recording, thus successfully clearing himself of suspicion. At this time, Clovis's death is finally reported. Soldiers who think that Britannians of pure blood should be in charge of the army, known as Purist Faction. Pilot Jeremiah, the leader of them, blames the murder of the prince on Suzuku to abolish the honorary Britannia system. Suzuku is the son of the last Japanese prime minister, Genbu Kuryugi, which provides Suzuku with a clear motive to kill the prince. Nunali is worried about Suzuku after hearing the news, and Lelouch also decides to save him. He controls a tailor with Gius to make himself a battle suit and mask. Then Lelouch asks Colin and her fellows to come to the tram and tells them only an army can defeat an army. Lelouch wants to interrogate the terrorists into an army to defeat Holy Britannia Empire. Colin and her fellow doesn't believe in Lelouch, so Lelouch decides to show them his power by rescuing Suzuku. The story of Suzuku killing the prince spreads all over the country, and many people in Area 11 honor him as a hero. On the other side, Jeremiah decides to guard the car personally in order to prevent carjacking. Lelouch asks Ogi and Colin to refit a car into Clovis's hearse and orders Colin to drive directly into the escort scene. Lelouch, wearing a mask, calls himself Zero and takes out the gas canister. Jeremiah doesn't know the truth about the gas canister, thinking that Lelouch just wants to take the people present as hostages. Lelouch claims to have killed Clovis and asks Jeremiah to release Suzuku. He controls Jeremiah with Gius to let go of them and releases poisonous gas to cause chaos, successfully escaping with Suzuku. After this, Ogi and his men all respect Lelouch. Lelouch wants to persuade Suzuku to join him and fight against Britannia. However, Suzuku believes that fighting violence with violence won't work. He wants to change the country from within and decides to go back to the military court to accept his trial. Lelouch calls him a fool, but Suzuku has already made up his mind and leaves. Suzuku is released because of insufficient evidence. Nunnally is very happy after hearing the news. At this moment, a person enters the room. It is none other than the green-haired girl who gave Lelouch power. On the other side, Cornelia, the second princess of the Empire, has conquered several Middle Eastern countries. After that, she is going to Area 11 as the Viceroy to avenge her younger brother, Clovis. When Lelouch returns home, he finds that the green-haired girl is folding paper with her sister. The girl claims herself as Cece and is mistaken by Nunnally as Lelouch's girlfriend. Lelouch makes an excuse to take Cece to his room, but no matter what Lelouch asks of her, she refuses to answer. She stays there and even occupies his bed. Considering that the military is still hunting Cece, so he has to let her stay before making next move. After getting Gius, Lelouch soon realizes that he could not fully rely on it. But the clever Lelouch fully learns his power after doing many tests. According to his research, Gius can only be used once by a person, and there is no limit to the number of people controlled at one time. It can penetrate transparent stuff such as glass, and can also be used with mirrors. Although it can only be used once per person, it works for as long as they are ordered. For example, a few months ago, he asked a girl to draw a mark on a wall every day, and she continues to do so now. Seeing that Lelouch has a full understanding of Gius, Cece shows more respect to him. But Lelouch knows clearly that his opponent is a huge empire, which cannot be underestimated. Cece cannot figure out why Lelouch, a Britannian, wants to fight against his country, and she thinks it is important to win by virtue of Gius alone. However, Lelouch thinks that this sad world is falling into a cycle of arrogance, prejudice, and hatred. Without breaking it, the world will never be peaceful. It is also very simple to achieve the goal, as long as one person wins. Lelouch thinks that the best way is to kill Charles, the Emperor of Britannia. On the other side, as Suzuku walks out of the prison, a girl falls from the sky and Suzuku quickly catches her. The girl calls herself Yuffie. She recognizes Suzuku and she asks him to play with her under the pretext of being pursued. In the end, Yuffie suddenly proposes to go into Shinjuku. In Shinjuku, they see some Britannian students who don't take the disaster in Area 11 seriously, and indignant Area 11 people, and then get involved in a fight because of Suzuku's identity as an honorary Britannian. At this time, they find that Jeremiah not far away is tricked to come here by his colleagues, who is going to kill him for letting Zero and Suzuku leave and debase the army. Just then, Lloyd comes to pick up Suzuku. Suzuku immediately drives Lancelot forward to stop the battle, while Violetta also comes to support Jeremiah. For a moment, the two sides are deadlocked. Suddenly, Yuffie runs over and orders them to stop fighting. It turns out that she is no one but Euphumia, the third prince of Britannia, Cornelia's sister, and the incoming son Viceroy of Area 11. "Just as you lost your father, I lost my brother Clovis," she says to Suzuku. "Will you help me ensure that no one will lose their loved ones again?" Suzuku promised her. So under the arrangement of Euphemia, Suzuku is sent in Ashford Academy and is in the same class with Lelouch.